whenever people talk about the difference between Git Merge and Git Rebase, it can get kind of confusing without some sort of visual. So here I just wanted to show you the end product of using both. In this example, we're using Git Merge, and what we're going to do is we're going to accept the current change, which is what's on my branch currently. As you can see, a merge commit is popping up. So after that, we have to make this commit. Now I'm going to push up this branch and you will see that this merge commit will actually be in the history of my branch on GitHub. So once I refresh this page, as you can see, there is a Git merge branch main to branch one, and that comes from using a merge commit. There is oftentimes no diff, as you can see here, when you click on this commit, but it does come from using Git merge main, and those are my changes looking good. Now let's go to the next example where we use rebase, and let's see what the difference is there. So now I'm just going to create a new branch off of main and name it like branch 2 rebase. I make some changes that I don't show and I didn't film here, but these changes are going to result in some merge conflicts. As you can see, this pops up, and incoming change is actually what's on the branch right now, whereas current change is what's on main. So that's one interesting aspect of Git merge and Git rebase, is that they kind of flip in VS Code once you get this UI, or in Vim, whichever editor you use. So I'm going to save my incoming change, commit, and continue with the rebasing. So once I do git log, you can see that it's real clean. There's no merge commit there. It's just all the changes on my branch. So now if you try to just use git push after you rebase, it's not gonna work. You have to force push. Okay, cool. So I force push my branch. As you can see, there are no merge commits. It is just my changes. That's it. And it just looks a little bit cleaner than having merge commits scattered throughout. This is the git merge branch. As you can see, there is a merge commit. At the same time, the end value is sort of the same. I have a branch that is up to date with main. Now let's go over the details of what we just saw. One quality of git merge is that it creates a merge commit. And this extra commit is one of developers' biggest complaints about git merge, since it can make the history of a branch look messy, especially if you don't have squash merge enabled for that repo. So what is in that merge commit? It technically has two parents, and for this reason, there's often no visual diff on GitHub. So if this is your branch in the blue, that merge commit is what's going to be in that gray circle. They both kind of point to that point. Git rebase, on the other hand, it reapplies commits on top of another base tip. And so what that means is that before you rebase, it looks like this. You have this like fork in the repo history where your branch is separate from what's on main. After rebasing successfully, it should look like this. So your branch is moved over to the latest on what's on Git rebase main. So as you can see, it looks a lot cleaner than what we saw previously, which is when that one commit had two parents. In rebasing your branch, you'll see this like step-by-step reapplication of commits. And this is why to some rebasing can be tedious, annoying, or seem more complicated. Depending on how many commits you have on your branch, you may just have to keep resolving the same conflicts over and over again. If you just joined a new team, ask for your team's opinion. If you're new to software development, Git merge is definitely a simpler starting point. As you progress as a developer, you probably will have to learn Git rebase eventually. Interactive rebasing, which we didn't go over in this high-level video, gives you the developer greater control of how your commits look and allows you to rewrite commit descriptions or squash commits altogether. I personally do not use it that often, but I do think it's pretty cool and seems useful if I really cared that much about what my commits look like. But anyway, I encourage you to check it out on your own if you are interested in using Git Rebase. And if you're new to learning rebasing, please check out a branch so that you don't accidentally destroy your branch. And this happens all the time to me, to developers who have been doing this for years. Like, rebasing can seriously mess up your branch if you're not careful. So just wanted to call out a little safety. But this is just my opinion. You should form your own, practice both now that you know like the high level difference between them. I hope this was helpful. My name is Carmel. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.